We have already studied one dimensional, two dimensional and three dimensional flow, which gives us small understanding of kinematics of fluid flow, that is flow of a fluid. To study this in detail, we'll consider a steady flow and an unsteady flow. Steady flow and unsteady flow. Now, what do you mean by steady flow? Steady flow is the flow of liquid in which, or a flow of fluid in which its fluid parameters are not dependent upon time. Means something is not dependent upon time. In mathematical expression, we can write that is velocity, acceleration, viscosity. All the three fluid parameters are not a function of time. Not a function of time means they are not dependent upon time. If they are not dependent upon time, this means the change with respect to time of all the fluid parameters will be zero. So this can be written as dv by dt is equals to zero. Change in acceleration versus time is equals to zero with respect to time is equals to zero, and change in viscosity with respect to time is equals to zero. Now we know that the velocity is a function of x, y, z and t. It is dependent upon four variables. Three variables are spatial coordinates or space coordinates, and the fourth variable is the time coordinate. So we can write down that is dou u by dou t is equals to zero, dou v by dou t is equals to zero, and dou w by dou t is equals to zero. Now why do we use d over here and dou over here? Because velocity is a function of one or more variables. That is why we use dou over here while considering the velocity along x direction, y direction and z direction. So this comprises of a steady flow. This comprises of steady flow. Now what is an unsteady flow? Unsteady flow is a flow in which we'll consider it is dependent upon time. That is, all the fluid properties are dependent upon time. That is, velocity, acceleration and viscosity are a function of time. That means your dou v by dou t is not equals to zero. Similarly, dou u by dou t is not equals to zero. Dou w by dou t is not equals to zero. Now during this entire part, we can write this in terms of differentials. Let us check out one differential for this entire unsteady flow. So we'll consider the u component of velocity. Now what is u component of velocity? That is velocity along x direction. That is, change in velocity along x direction is not equals to zero. If it is not equals to zero, either this part will be greater than zero or this part will be less than zero. If it is greater than zero, the velocity along that direction is increasing. If it is less than zero, then the velocity along that direction is decreasing. Let us consider if it is increasing. So you will write this differential as dou u by dou t is equals to, it is not equals to zero. If it is not equals to zero, either it is greater or less. We'll consider this k as greater than zero. A variable has a positive value. So if you cross multiply, that is dou u is equals to k into dou t, and if you integrate over an entire limits, or just if we integrate, you'll get this as U is equals to KT plus C. That means U is a function of time and it is dependent upon time. Hence, this flow is called as what? Unsteady flow. I hope you have understood what is basic difference between steady flow and unsteady flow. One is dependent upon time, which is unsteady flow. One is independent upon time, which is steady flow. Thank you.